हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द एंगुलर एंड लीनियर विड्थ ऑफ द सेंट्रल मैक्सिमम, राइट? सो वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द कंडीशन फॉर फर्स्ट मिनिमम सेंट्रल मैक्सिमम ऑलरेडी इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स, राइट? सो टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट एंगुलर एंड लीनियर विड्थ. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल we discuss about the angular width. So the width of central maximum is the distance between the first minimum on either side of the central maximum, right? We can easily say that, because suppose this is the central maxima, right? And suppose here there is the first minimum. So the width of central maximum is the distance between the first minimum here and the either side of the central maximum, right? So here this is the first minimum, like this part, right? So here this is the width of the central maxima, right? So you can see that here this is the slit, and we know that the width of slit is very small. We already know that the distance between slit and screen is capital D. So you can see here that this is the slit, so here the width of slit is A. This is the central maxima. Suppose this angle is theta, so this is also theta. So the angular width is theta plus theta, 2 theta, right? So the angular width of central maximum is theta plus theta is equals to 2 theta. But we know that theta is equals to lambda by A, right? We already prove this formula in previous lectures, right? So for a minimum of one side of central maximum on screen is given by theta is equals to lambda by A, right? So here we can say that this theta is the half of the angular width, because angular width is theta plus theta, 2 theta. So the theta is known as the half the width of the angular width. So we know that theta is equals to lambda by A. We have to find out the angular width of the central maximum to theta. So simply we have to multiply by 2 both sides. So we can get 2 theta is equals to 2 lambda by A, right? So you can see here that for a minimum of one side of central maximum on the screen, theta is equals to lambda by A, where this theta is the half of the width of angular width. So to find out the angular width to theta, we have to multiply both sides with 2. So we get 2 theta is equals to 2 lambda by A, right? Once again, the width of central maximum is the distance between the first minimum on the either side of the central maximum. Now we know that the width of slit is small a, which is very small. The distance between slit and screen is capital D. So here you can see that in this figure the width of slit is small a. This is the angle theta plus theta, 2 theta, which is known as the angular width. This beta 0 is known as the linear width of the central maximum. But first of all, we have to discuss for the angular width. So we know that theta is equals to lambda by a. We have to find out the angular width theta plus theta to theta. So here we multiply both sides by 2. So we get 2 theta is equals to 2 lambda by a, right? So you have to remember this equation. Angular width is equals to 2 theta is equals to 2 lambda by a, right? Now you already know about the plane angle, right? You know that the plane angle is equals to arc upon radius, right? So here see this. So the angle is theta plus theta, 2 theta. So the formula of plane angle is equals to arc upon radius. So here the plane angle is theta plus theta, 2 theta. So 2 theta is equals to arc, which is beta 0, divided by radius, which is capital D. So we can write that 2 theta is equals to arc B0 upon radius capital D. So 2 theta is equals to beta 0 by D, right? So we can write that 2 theta is equals to arc, which is B0 upon radius capital D, right? So the arc B0 is equals to 2 theta into capital D, right? But we know that 2 theta is equals to 2 lambda by a, right? So B0 is equals to 2 theta is 2 lambda by a into D. So we can say that the arc B0 is equals to 2 lambda capital D by a, right? Suppose this is our equation number 1, right? Now we discuss about the n plus 1th order minimum. So we can say that this is the B0 arc is known as the width of the linear central maximum, right? Because it is the minimum distance between the central maximum distance. So here arc B0 is width of linear central maximum, right? Because you can see in this figure, this is the arc B0, which is known as the linear width, right? So the arc B0 is equals to 2 theta into D, but we know that 2 theta is equals to 2 lambda by A, right? So 2 lambda by A into capital D, right? Now we discuss about the n plus 1th order and nth order. So suppose for nth order, we can say that theta is equals to lambda by A. But for nth order, we can say that theta n is equals to n lambda by A, right? And for n plus 1th order, we can say that n plus 1 lambda by A, right? So we can write that for nth order theta n is equals to n lambda by A, number 2. And for n plus 1th order theta n plus 1 is equals to n plus 1 lambda by A, number 3, right? Now the angular width of n secondary maximum. Suppose we have to find out the angular width. So simple, we have to subtract theta n from theta n plus 1, right? So angular width is equals to theta n plus 1 minus theta n, right? So value of theta n plus 1 is n plus 1 into lambda by a minus n lambda by a. So here we multiplied lambda to n and with 1. So n lambda by a plus lambda by a, we can write that, right? Because n into lambda by a, so n lambda by a plus 1 into lambda, lambda by a minus n lambda by a. So here n lambda by a cancel. So we can say that angular width is equals to lambda by a. So here the angular width is lambda by a, and we know that the linear width is angular width into d, right? Because see here, arc is equals to 2 theta into d, right? This arc is known as the linear width. 2 theta is the angular width. So we can say that the linear width is equals to angular width into capital D, right? So we can write that linear width is equals to angular width into capital D, right? We can write that. Now the angular width is lambda by a into d, right? So we get linear width is equals to lambda by a into d. Suppose for this difference between n and n plus 1, we denoted linear width by beta. So we can say that beta is equals to lambda into capital D by a, right? So see here friends, here see, beta 0 is equals to 2 lambda capital D by a. So if we have to find out lambda capital D by a, so we can say that lambda into capital D by a is equals to beta 0 by 2, right? So we can write that from equation 1, lambda into capital D by a is equals to b0 by 2. See here, lambda capital D by a is equals to beta 0, or we can say b0 by 2, beta 0 by 2, right? So see here, beta is equals to lambda into capital D by a. So we know that the lambda capital D by a is beta 0 by 2. So this is equation number 4. So from equation 4, we can say that beta is equals to the value of lambda D by a is beta 0 by 2. So from equation number 4, beta is equals to beta 0 by 2, right? So we can say that beta 0 is equals to 2 into beta, right? So this is the relation between beta 0 and beta, right? Again, see here, we already know that theta is equals to lambda by a, right? Now the angular width is theta plus theta, 2 theta. So here we multiplied by 2 both sides. So we get angular width 2 theta is equals to 2 lambda by a, right? So we can say that the angular width is 2 lambda by a. Now again, we know that plane angle here theta plus theta 2 theta is equals to arc beta 0 upon radius capital D. So 2 theta is equals to arc beta 0 upon radius capital D. So arc beta 0 is 2 theta into capital D. So beta 0 is value of 2 theta is 2 lambda by a. So 2 lambda by a into D. So here this arc B0 is known as the linear width, right? So suppose if we want to write angular width for nth and n plus 1th order, so we can say that n for nth order theta n is equals to n lambda by a, for n plus 1th order theta n plus 1 is equals to n plus 1 lambda by a. So angular width is, we have to subtract theta n from theta n plus 1. So theta n plus 1 minus theta n. So by putting the values of theta n plus 1 and theta n, we get n plus 1 lambda by a minus n lambda by a. Here we multiply lambda with n and with 1. So n lambda by a plus 1 into lambda, lambda by a minus n lambda by a. So n lambda by a cancel. So we get angular width is equals to lambda by a. But here beta 0 is width of linear central maximum. So linear width, right? So linear width is equals to 2 theta, which is angular width into capital D. So we can say that linear width is equals to angular width into capital D. Suppose for n and n plus 1th order, we denote a linear width by beta. So we get beta is equals to, the angular width is lambda by a into capital D. But see here, we have to find out value of lambda into capital D by a. So see here, lambda into capital D by a, so 2 goes to left hand side, so we get lambda capital D by a is equals to beta 0 by 2. So from equation 1 we get lambda D by a is equals to B0 by 2. So lambda D by a is equals to B0 by 2. So from this equation number 4, see beta is equals to lambda D by a, and we know that lambda D by a is beta 0 by 2. So we get beta is equals to beta 0 by 2. So beta 0 is equals to 2 into beta. So you have to remember this equation, right? So this is the formulas of linear and angular width of the central maximum. You have to remember these formulas. Okay, thank you.